I swear, man, I thought of at least three different videos to make, just walking into the other room, getting coffee, and coming back. And where do I start? One was there are so many things going on right now, and in life, in your life, in my life, in the world, and I'm wondering about your emotional response to that. Are you holding up okay? Stressing out? Are you a roller coaster? One day good, one day bad, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Reason I'm asking is because that's what's happening with me. It's like one day good, one day bad, one day good, one day bad, one day good, 2 days bad, one day good, 2 days, 3 days, one step forward, three step back, kind of shit like, is that what the fuck's going on? But then every now and then a kafoom, and I'll come back again. I'm looking good, feeling good. Emotionally, spiritually, about what's going on in the world, what's going on with me on the inside. Because outside is a reflection of inside, right? That's what they say. Holy shit. And what the fuck are you doing here anyway on planet I love you, Earth? What are you doing here? What the hell? This place is a piece of work. Yeah? Okay. Just checking. Wow. So, that was one video. The other video, was it a video about slowing down the. Oh, yeah, I remember. It was like I was going to start the video like this. It was like, hey, how you doing? How's your heart? How's your liver, bitch? How are your kidneys doing? How's your neurological system doing? Your nervous system? Is it okay? Are you looking good? How old are you? 8? No. How old are you? Are you over 40? Are you starting to feel it? I can make a whole video about slow down the aging process with my LifeWave X39 stem cell activation patches. The motherfuckers work. Holy. You probably did you see my last video? I just made it a few minutes ago. It's like, holy shit. I would not have even thought about me being 74 years old, 75. I'll be 75 in like less than 12 months. 70. Fuck you. No way. Yeah, way. Yeah. But it seems like everything kind of stopped, like getting older when I started doing those LifeWave patches last year. Yeah. Been doing them about 14 months now. It just went, err. And I had a chronic back pain for 20 fucking years. I injured my back when I was a kid. And it kind of got better. Then I injured it again. It kind of got better. Then I injured it again about 20 fucking years ago, around 2000. And chronic, lower back, bend over, go to chiropractor. I used to go to chiropractors a lot. Nothing. Nah. It's gone. The thing, whatever it was, gone. Doesn't hurt. That bend over, ow, that hurts. Stand up thing, no. Stem cells apparently got activated in my spinal column, in the vertebrae, and the discs that were damaged, fucked up, and then my body healed itself. Yeah, I guess. And at my age, come on. If you're getting, seriously, if you're getting concerned about you're getting older and your body's not doing what it's, you'd like it to do as far as holding up, just kind of think, okay, if this fell apart this year, what's going to happen 2 years from now, 5 years from now? How's it going to look? And then if you got some rheumatism, arthritis starting to happen, swelling, inflammation, that kind of shit. What if your brain's swelling, inflammation in the brain damage, cell damage to your brain? Chemtrails. Our fun and loving chemtrails. Yeah. Brain damage. You can snort that fucking aluminum, nanoparticles of aluminum from chemtrails right up your freaking nose, and it'll cross the blood-brain barrier. My opinion. I don't know. I'm not a medical doctor. I got to do this now on YouTube. So I'm like, slow down, YouTube. I'm just talking here. But yeah, it seems to me, it's quite possible, when you're snorting the fucking barium and the strontium and the aluminum nanoparticles out of the chemtrail smoke, they go right to your brain, start damaging your shit. And I personally think it has something to do with Alzheimer's. I do. It's killing the brain faster than your body can repair the brain. Your body needs brain cells to repair the brain. And when your body gets older, you can't generate brain cells as fast. So then you've also got backup. You got stem cells that can turn into brain cells. But the body stops kicking out the stem cells in abundance. You know, the normal level of stem cells that you can kick out in your 20s and 30s and late 30s starts to go, phew. By the time you're 50, your ability to kick out the stem cells just like sucks. And so that's what I learned when I got my little stem cell activation patch. And apparently something's working because the old ticker's working fine. I used to get arrhythmia, that weird irregular heartbeat. And then it would stop and be normalish. Or you could listen and go bum ba bum 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 bum. What the fuck is that? When I was 40, I went to the doc about that shit. They wanted to throw me right now, right fucking now, on some little white pills to normalize my heartbeat. It's like, fuck you. Jesus Christ. I just let it go. So I went with arrhythmia, irregular heartbeat, for about another 20 fucking years. I don't really think about it because it's not a problem, but I don't get that anymore. Normalized heartbeat. I've got some friends that got these LifeWave patches and they had arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and one of their parents had rheumatoid arthritis. It's like really fucked up shit. I don't know what the hell, except he bought more. He bought a fucking year's supply of the fuckers. You know what I'm talking about, right? Oh, man. So, yeah. So, I started this video. I just had a lot of different ideas for videos. Are you still with me? If you're still with me, let me rattle off some other weird shit. Has to do with timelines and reality, and how timelines, yes, they do exist, you know, the linear time track and your past life in a linear timeline, and thus your future is coming on. But there's another aspect of all this creation stuff that it's all now. It's already manifest. What? So not only do we have future lives, we have multiple past lives. So if this is now, and this is all these potential futures, you just make this decision, you go here, you make this decision, you go here. This decision will take you down this. Your life will change, so you'll be on a different timeline. But same with the past, though. You have this one and this one. I go, what? No, really? Is that what? Huh? How does that work? Well, it takes a while to wrap your head around it. But the same way you can change your future, you can change your past? ? What the hell? What does that even mean? If there's many potential futures, and you tune into one as your chosen future, and you play out your life, and it really evolves around you, and you manifest it on a unconscious super level of manifestation of reality in the now, time isn't going on. You're creating time by experiencing like frame rates in a video. You speed the video up, it seems like time went faster for you. Everybody's running around talking real fast and all this stuff. And time goes by faster when you speed up the experience of the consecutive time frames. You're on a time track. Well, when we create a moment in time, we're creating a moment that's a holographic projection of this right now, my reality, my physical reality experience. Monitor, camera, lamp, PC, desk, books, all that stuff. The big me is manifesting this all about me, and the little me is going, ooh, look, time's going by. Oh, it's, I'm not as young as I used to be. Kind of like that. But on another level, we're just manifesting one moment after another, and they're each one a consecutive now. But if that's true, then there's all these potential tracks, and you hear about this idea that all these other potentials actually exist. All things in existence are actually right now. That's how we tune into it. Like, you can literally, this is me just talking here, thinking about ways, videos to make. Oh, I can make a video about this. So this one is about the time and stuff. And you can, God, starting to go blank. Oh, don't go blank. Don't go blank. Please don't go blank. Blank. Fuck. You ever do that? Go, y'all talking along and you, yep. You go fucking blank. I need more patches, man. I need more fucking patches, man. I don't know, fix my brain. Oh, by the way, stream of consciousness bullshit video, right? Well, yeah, so. But I told you guys, some of you know this because I repeated it several times, but my uncle died of Alzheimer's. And then my other uncle died of Alzheimer's. And my aunt that is still alive, she's about 14 years older than me, she's got Alzheimer's. And then my memory starts going sideways. Like, huh? What? You know, mental different thing. I go, oh, fuck. Is this stuff genetic? Nah. Is it programmed? Nah. Is it environmental? I don't know. But oh, shit. I don't want that happening to me. So, these stem cell activation patches, yeah, I think they helped a lot, because I'm a lot sharper and friskier than I have been. And this continuously, year after year, I can sense and feel memory sucking a little more and a little more and a little more. And I go, oh, fuck, not Alzheimer's. No, please, God, say it's not true. And things have stabilized in that direction. I still get the occasional, huh? What was I talking about? Where are my keys? You have a car? I don't know. Check out back. Yeah, I have a car. Well, no, it's a pickup. Oh, okay. It's not that fucking bad. But yeah, I'm hanging in there, man. Hanging in there. But we were talking about time and manifesting time around us. And holy shit. We can, we manifest our lives by programming that super conscious or super subconscious, unconscious, part of our creative ability that is creating this reality around us. This is like a daydream world right here. This is like somebody with a good visual, vivid imagery could imagine a classroom and surrounded in a classroom and like be in it, touch and feel this and walk around in it. And it's just their daydream. I met a lot of people like that. And that's all this physical world is. Except we're agreeing with others that this daydream is the real reality. But we're creating it. So we're tuning into the consensus reality. We're all connected telepathically. It's like there's the internet web of humanity on an unconscious, subconscious level. A lot like in Neo, the Matrix. Everybody's in a pod, and the pod is connected into everybody through their fucking neck, spinal cord, and they're dreaming the same dream. They're all getting the same dream, or they're spinning the same dream together. You know, it's a little fuzzy about what they're exactly, the tech in the movie is like. But yeah, consensus reality, that's all of us humans and everybody else agreeing to this reality experience, this daydream. And by definition, we call it real because we all agree that you can touch this and see that and do that and everything else. But in fact, this place plays out by virtue of what you think, feel, focus on, predominantly dialogue internally about, and it's your expression of reality through the filters of what you filtered in. You think and feel certain things because of what you see, and then you think and feel it, and then you manifest it around you. And the bad boys, the cabal gang, the dark side that's running the show, is trying to manipulate the mass consciousness of humanity to take us to a dark place, you know, to an icky, dystopian sort of world domination control sort of experience. But they're having a little problem there because not enough of us are buying into their bullshit, right? So we stay on top of it and go, no, that's not true. That's not how it is. You know, it's like this. And you imagine a little better or a great, much better scenario and reality system. And your predominant thoughts, feelings, and focus will help you get there. Well, meantime, they're out there doing all this shit and throwing this shit at us. Social media and mainstream media and radio, television, music, movies, books. They're just trying all this stuff. They're throwing at us to get us to think and feel and thus manifest what they would like us to manifest. So that we will feel more icky. And when we feel shitty by having focused on, thought about, and felt about, and manifested negativity, which then makes us feel even more negative and bummed out and depressed and, you know, crappy, then that's exactly what their plan is, so that they can feed off of us like psychic parasites, energy vampires, incubus, succubus, archons, demons, all that shit. Yeah. So that's another video I can make. I don't know. Just talking here. All right. Okay, I'm all talked out. I'm going to go now. If you got this far, let me know what you thought about my little stream of consciousness. What the fuck am I going to make a video about? Approach to making a video. I'll tell you one thing. Oh, I started out like this up and down thing. That seems to be never ending. It's like the challenge that we're here for. I mean, nobody came, I guess some people came here to have fun, but this is not normally a fun place. This place is full of obstacles and challenges and threats and evil people and injustice. Yeah. And it's like, why the fuck would I agree to something like that? Why would I do this to myself? Who would do this to themselves? Well, we have to take a really different perspective and look at this place as a drop in the bucket. And what can you learn here by coming? How would this benefit me? What would be the value of me coming in and living a life like this? And then you see people around you, you know, it's a lot worse for them. You know, oh, shit. Why the fuck would anybody do that? What if they're an NPC? There's nobody home there, dude. What if that? NPCs are all over the fucking place. I heard that 1 out of 5 people are real, and the others are non-player characters. Nobody home. They're organic, run by AI or some fucking program of some sort, but they're not real people. But you can't tell. You really can't tell. If some of you can tell the difference between a real person and an NPC, give me a shout out down here and tell me how you can tell. It's a challenge. I got to the point where, you know, it doesn't fucking matter. Just look at a crowd of people. There's about 100 people out here. Yeah, about 20 of them are real. I just go with the numbers and I'm like, eh. But do I treat one different from another? No, I don't really talk to any of them. No, I'm friendly and I say hi. And California, just the personality and characters, we're friendly. We say hi to each other and stuff like that. Generally speaking. But yeah. What a life, huh? So, if you got something out of this, way to go, man. Yeah, I'm just talking here. I want to share some ideas I have for videos. And you can share some ideas you have for videos that I might make. And we'll just go from there. Last thing I want to talk about is how to create your reality by looking into your past and rewriting the past. Re-envision it. Revise, Neville Goddard style, revise the story. Yeah. Cosmic Agency, Swaru 9. She's talking about that in a recent video I watched. How you can reimagine your past and change your past, which will change your present time and thus your future. It's really deep, neat stuff. Okay, I guess that's it for now. Thanks again for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.